Coming to the last program from this chapter, the exercise program. Here in this program, you need to extract only the domain names, and dictionary has to be created for this, where you need to keep a count on how many times each domain name has been repeated here. For example, you can see here, once you give the file name either the mbox.txt or mboxshort.txt, the result needs to be a dictionary where it has to contain only the domain names as a key with corresponding value that how many times each domain name has been repeated here. So let's see how to get the solution to this program here. So for that, what we need to do is we need to first open a file. Either you can open the mbox.txt or the mboxshort.txt file. So the logic remains same for going through the contents of the file. So always, if you remember the contents of the file, you know where this part of the information is present in the file. For example, I need not have to show you every time what is the behavior of this line in the entire file. So you know from where you have this content. So thing is that you will get this required content in the both the lines. That is either the line if it begins with the from, or even if the line it begins with the from colon. So you can write a program to go for searching using the both the lines, or can you can or else you can exclude the line which begins with the from colon here. So we'll try to exclude it. That means basically through which kind of the lines we'll be able to get this kind of information is if line dot starts with from. So this time we'll try to extract all the lines which begins with the from. Try to leave the part where we put the restriction that line should not be considered if it starts with the from colon. So we'll search only this much. So in that case, we need to split the line in order to extract all the parts of the line. So if you remember the content of a file, you'll be able to make that at which index value you'll be able to get the required information there. The entire email ID is present at the index value 1. At the 0th position, you have the from. At the index value 1, you have the email ID. So in that case, what you can do is email, you just take it as an email is equal to line of 1, which will give you the entire email address to be extracted here. So we have to create a certain variables which we require here. So a dictionary variable to create a dictionary of the domain names. A list variable to store the email. We might require the another list variable to extract only the domain part. I'll tell you what is the difference here with both these variables, or what you are going to store in both these variables. Now if you print the email, you'll get to know what information has been retrieved here. So if I run this program, you can see here, I'll be able to extract all the email IDs here, including the username @symbol and the entire information which is present at the index value 1. As you can see here, so you are able to extract all these information zqin@umich.edu. So similarly, for the all the lines, you are able to extract the entire email ID. But the aim of this program, what does it tells here? You are not interested in the entire email ID. Instead, you need to extract only the domain names here. Domain name needs to be extracted. Excuse me. So here you can see only the domain name has to be extracted here. So what common thing that you can find here in order to extract the domain name? So always the domain name in any email ID is going to lie after the @ character. So do remember here that you should be able to understand the which part of the information you want to retrieve from the content of the file. So with this lines of the codes, we are able to successfully extract all the email IDs, but we are not interested again in only the email IDs. We are rather interested only in the domain names from the each email ID here. So what is a common thing that you can observe here is all the domain names are going to be appearing after the @ character. That means what you need to modify in this entire program now. Once you retrieve the email ID, you need to again use the one more split function in order to retrieve only the domain names here. So for that, I'll take another variable as a domain. So this email variable, this particular variable consists the entire email ID. For this, what I want to do, I want to apply the split method. But here instead of the space parameter, I want it should be the @ symbol. Why? Because all the domain names are going to appear after this @ character. So if you split accordingly, you will be able to extract only the domain names here. If you want, you can print and see here what will be the values in the So you can see here. Just pause. So since you have applied the split function, you can see you have used the space, @ symbol as a delimiter over there. That means the username is going to be the first entry and the second name is the only the domain names here. Isn't it? So the list has been created. So within this list, one more thing I want to tell you, within this list you have only the two elements here. At the 0th index position you have the username, at 1th index position you have the domain name. That means what you want to do here is you want to, instead of printing all the domain names, I want the another list variable which has been already created here to store only the domain names, isn't it? So what I have to do here, I want to use this list _ domain and I want to append the contents of this domain variable, so the only the host names, right? So if I print this list variable, you will get to know that only the domain name has been added to this list. You can see here, you have the n number of the lines here. So we'll create, rather than going through this, what I will do, we'll create the dictionary for that to keep a count on the a number of how many times the each domain name has been repeated here. For here you need to put the index, right? So which I have mistaken with the previous execution, isn't it? So once you extract the once you apply the split on the email ID, this domain variable will contain the two entries in it, the first entry being the username and the second entry in this list will be the host name. So we are not interested in both the contents, instead we are interested only in the content which is at the index value 1, that is the host name. So next, what you need to do here, you need to add these into the list. What you want to append, you want to append the domain name here. So now you can apply the for loop on this list where you have added all the host names in this list. Then use the dictionary which you have created, dict underscore domain. So that's it, what we are interested here. There was a mistake in the syntax here. Here it should be, instead of dot, it should be equal to. So now you can see here what you got as a result. So here you can see the dictionary has been created where the keys in this dictionary are only the host name followed by the value being how many times the each host name has been repeated here. So if you consider the any entry within this dictionary, the key will be the only the host name followed by a value, that is how many times that particular host has been repeated. So this was the expected result for this last program here. So all the programs are exactly similar. Only thing that you need to remember in the programs is how to create a dictionary, how you can use a list, and the how to use the split method, and most importantly you should know the content of this file, how, what is the behavior of the required line for which you want to extract, and within that line how you will be able to extract the required information that has been asked in your question. So accordingly you can apply the split method, and you should be able to remember at which index value you have the required information that has been asked in your question. So the rest part is exactly same what we did for the other previous programs, that how to create a dictionary, how to keep a count on the objects. The logic for this is going to remain same for the all the programs. I hope the solutions for all these exercise programs is clear to you. So in order to get perfection in it, I request all of you to try the execution. Then only the things will be more clear for you. Thank you.